All right, guys, so if you look here, we're going to take a look at the radius and the ulna. So right here, this is going to be our ulna, which is on the pinky side. This is going to be the radius, which is on the thumb side. But what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at each bone individually. So we're going to start ahead with the ulna. So if you look here at the ulna, we have this little notch right here on the ulna. That's actually called the radial notch. It's caused by the head of the radius, causes that depression. Actually, where that depression is actually what we call the proximal radial ulnar joint, which is a synovial pivot joint, and it allows for pronation and supination. I'm going to show you guys here. If I take the head of the radius right here and fit that in right there, that's actually going to show us the proximal radial ulnar joint. All right, so let's keep going. So if you look up here at the top part here, you see this like nice little process, this pointy part of it. That's called the olecranon process. It fits right into the olecranon fossa of the humerus and forms a synovial hinge joint. So does this. This is also a synovial hinge joint where the coronoid process of the ulna fits into the coronoid fossa of the humerus and forms that synovial hinge joint. And I'm going to turn it a little bit right here, this part right here, this little scoop thing, that is the trochlear notch. That's what articulates with the trochlea. Okay, if you remember, it's the medial condyle of the humerus. Okay, and that's also going to form a synovial hinge joint. Then what I'm going to do is we're going to come down the ulna right here. And then we're going to be right here. If you see this little pointy thing right there, that's the styloid process of the ulna. And then what's interesting is this whole thing at the bottom is actually going to be the head of the ulna. So the head of the ulna and then the styloid process of the ulna. All right, guys, so now we're going to take a deeper look at the radius. So if we look here at the radius, this is going to be the head of the radius right there. That's, again, what causes that depression in the ulna, which we talked about was the proximal radial ulnar joint. Another thing is the head of the radius actually causes that depression in the humerus called the radial fossa. This is the radial tuberosity here. And then there's some ligaments that actually wrap right around this region called the annular ligaments. And actually what allows for pronation and supination. Now we're going to go ahead and bring this guy this way so that you guys can see this part right here. This part right here, I want to show this. This is actually called the ulnar notch. And if you look, guys, you can see here that this right here where the head of the ulna is, it attaches right there. That is going to be the ulnar notch that's causing there. But now if you look here, this is another joint. This is actually the distal radial ulnar joint. And then again, this is actually going to be a synovial pivot joint, which allows for pronation and supination. All right, so now we're going to get this ulna out of there. We're going to come back over here, and we're going to take a look at the radius here. I want to look at one more part here, and this is actually going to be called the styloid process. And again, so remember that the styloid processes are going to be at the distal end, and these are what allow for articulation to the carpal bones, as well as the other styloid processes on the ulna, which allow for articulation with the carpal bones. All right, guys, that pretty much gives us everything we need to know about the radius and the ulna.